Well, the story is it's based on the true story of Grace Marks, who immigrated from Northern Ireland to Canada in the 1840s. She worked as a housemaid and was tried and convicted of the murder of Nancy Montgomery and her landowner, whose name is escaping me right now because I'm so nervous. And she goes to prison for 15 years and then she's pardoned. Dr. Jordan over
here. She wasn't actually in it. You can tell. She's fake. She's fake. You're a fraud.
The show is centered around this series of interviews between Grace and her psychologist, Dr. Jordan.
Yeah.
And he's trying to figure out whether or not she really did it. And you're going to try and figure out whether or not she really did it, too, when you watch the show.
He gets sort of led down a bit of a maze, really. His whole journey is ambiguous. I think from the moment he meets Grace, she sort of concocts a web of... I don't want to say what the web is of.
It's a web.
But it's a web.
It's a web.
And it's a web that he can't help himself, and he goes down. So I think the idea is that you never really know anything in this series. You never come to... You never land on a conclusion. Simon doesn't land on a conclusion. I didn't land on a conclusion when I read it. I took a lot of thought, and I still have moments where I'm like...
It's the type of piece that you really get lost in. Margaret has this way of putting words to how we process the most traumatic events in our life, in our subconscious. She somehow manages to achieve that subjectivity on the page. That's what makes her characters so fascinating and so dimensional. And so to be able to, I couldn't pick anybody better than Sarah Polley to have adapted this, because Sarah's writing is also the same. And so that's why it was such an opportunity, a rich opportunity for us to be a part of this show, because Sarah, the world that Sarah created is so palpable.
Amazing.
Yeah.
It's very rare when you read scripts that the world that the writer has created on the page, that you feel it and you can sense it and you're almost in it when you're reading, let alone, like, most of the stuff happens in production when they create the sets. But this was all there on the page. So I bought into that world. I was living there by the time I finished it. And that's like a real telltale of a really amazing writer. Like, it was incredible.
You know, as Canadians and really globally, we need to be thinking about how we're treating immigration. We need to think about the role of women in our society. And so I think all of those things are very relevant things to be thinking about today. But what's really interesting is that she deals with those themes in this, like, very compelling love story, in this very compelling murder, and this kind of mystery as to whether or not Grace committed these murders.
Here is, Sarah, my final question. Obviously, when you're playing a character who has so many perceptions placed upon her, does that make it more challenging when you're trying to satisfy all of those different interpretations at once for people?
Yes, it was a challenge, but it was a welcome challenge, because I got to play so many different versions of Grace, so many different versions of what could have happened, and that was a welcome challenge for me and for Edward.
What she said.